Captain Torrance, Flight Commander. How can I help you?
Fugitive extradition.
Oh, is he dangerous? What did he do?
Homicide 15 years ago.
It's Tara Hitchcock from Harkins Theaters, which is where people get to see this plane go down in the middle of the jungle. And fortunately, you guys are on board.
Love it.
But there's so many things that you can talk about as it relates to just airplane travel in general. And I'm curious, when was the last time you guys had a pilot greet you as you boarded the plane?
Dramatic license. Okay. I see the dig. No, it doesn't happen very, very frequently. That has to be said, but it felt like a nice touch for the movie.
I loved it.
Yeah. I thought it was a nice touch too. I have seen it happen like twice, but I fly a lot. It's like, I mean, that's a 0.002%. But they're always usually not a lot. Yeah, no, they're usually standing when you leave though. So, I mean, I've seen guys walk through the aisle and say hello, which is sort of, again, it's just arming to see the guy walking through the aisle, but a handful of times they'll walk through the aisle and they'll tell you what's going on and tell you the weather and all sorts of stuff. And it catches me off guard, but I like it. I'm not going to lie.
I'd be like, hey, should you not be flying the plane? Which is kind of what I thought in the movie when I went back to speak to everybody. Is anybody going to say to me, hey, like, we're kind of in the middle of a terrible storm right now. Who's flying the plane?
The ballhead guy was thinking that. He's like, what are you doing? Get out of here. Get back in the cockpit.
So that's interesting. My husband has his pilot's license and I watched it with him. So there was one moment, Gerard, where I was wondering that and he was explaining that you're actually okay. You know, yeah. And he was telling me all about it. What are some of your travel routines on an airplane? Do you like the window? Are you an aisle guy?
Yeah, I'm a window guy. I like the view. I like to hide, you know, so like baseball cap down, then like, oh, pretty clouds.
Noise canceling headphones. I like to bring my own water. I got to get some water before I get on a plane. I like the aisle seat, and that's pretty much it. And if I can, I like the eye mask. So if I want to take a nap, I can get, you know, cover my eyes too.
By the way, I also like to take as many things out of my bag as possible and then try and keep my bag down there. But they always catch me and they go, sir, you got to put your bag up top. But I'm like, you know, I might happen to read one of these six books that I'm taking out or write notes in this book. And the next minute, the people around me are like, what the hell are you doing? Because I know empty. Yeah, I'm that annoying guy spilling drinks. Going, oh, I'm so sorry.
He's got to be low key. He's like, I got my baseball cap down, but I'm going to be an annoying. And I'm going to have my whole stuff spread out here.
No, the baseball cap's just to pretend that I don't want to be recognized. I'm my mind because I actually do want to be recognized.
He pulls out all of his VHSs and the posters and he's signing autographs and stuff. And he's just like, he's watching his own movie.
This is an emergency. I'm Captain Brody Torrance.
In a day and age where we are really spoiled by action sequences, I must say there were several that were fantastic. And Gerard, the one kind of that one-on-one with you and the pirate in that confined space really was wonderful. How do you, at a time where we get spoiled by that stuff, really make something that surprises us and is that entertaining and that good?
Well, yeah, I'm glad you chose that one because I actually think cinematically that scene's going to be pretty remembered because to explain to the audience, it's hard to shoot an action scene at the best of times, but normally you break it down. You break it down into six different bits with maybe six hits in each, and you have various cameras and you work out each hit for the camera. We had one camera, we did the whole scene in one, and it's a long fight, and every hit had to work because if one even misses slightly, the whole thing is useless, you know. So that and that day, and that was your first day on set. So he was watching. So I knew I had to bring my game up.
No, he brought it.
But it was like 105 degrees on the heat index. It was 100% humidity, and I'm doing that fight. And I tell you, every time I got to about halfway through, I actually couldn't get any breath in. I thought I didn't think, do I just keep going because I actually can't breathe. It was so intense. But it was so perfect for that because the fight is so desperate. It's just fighting for your life. And I felt not even my life, because if I die, I felt like all the rest of the passengers are going to die. I'm the only way of getting in touch with the outside world is what I'm trying to do right there.
We're getting off this island.